Hi, my friends. This is Nellie from Classroom A. I'm back, and we're going to continue writing with our whiteboard. So for our activity, we should know we need our whiteboard, a damp cloth or tissue to erase our board, and two different color dry erase markers, one for your uppercase and one for your lowercase letters. Let's review the letters that we've been working on so far, and then I'll introduce the letters that we're going to do today. We did A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O. Today we're going to do P, Q, and R. That's what we're going to work on today. All right. Our first letter we're going to do is P. Very good. Who knows what sound the letter P makes? You heard it. Puh, puh. Very good. Who remembers what activity we did this year for the letter P? What animal did we make when we were doing our farm study? Yes, a pig. We made the letter P, pig. Very good. Now we're going to write the letter P. Let's get my black marker. We're going to start our letters at the top. You're going to draw a straight line down. Then you're going to pick your marker up and go back to the top. And you're going to go around with a bump, just like we did with our letter B. But we're only going to do the one bump up top. And this is the uppercase P. Very good. Let's make one more. Start at the top, go down, pick your marker up, go back to the top. You're going to give it a one bump. Very good. That's our uppercase letter P. Now let's make our lowercase P. Lowercase P looks the same, right? Just a little smaller. We're going to start it down lower. And you're going to go start at the top again. Draw the line down. Pick your marker up. Go to the top. And do the same thing for a lower P. A lowercase P. The lowercase P is always down a little bit lower. And when you start writing on your lines, you see the uppercase P here? It does both, top to bottom. The lowercase P starts in the middle and goes to the bottom because it's smaller. And you guys will learn that when we start writing with our lined paper. And let's do another lowercase P. Start at the top, go down. Come to the top of your line and give it one bump. That's how we make our lowercase P. Good job, my friends. Let's erase P and move on to our next letter. Our next letter is Q. Who knows what Q sounds like? Qua, qua. Quilt, quarter. Very good. All right, let's figure out how to make this letter Q. Yes, you're right, it does look like the letter O that we did the other day. So let's start at the top and let's make a letter O. Okay, and what else does the letter Q have? Yes, it looks like kind of like a tally mark or a little slash right here in the bottom right-hand corner. That's how we make the uppercase letter Q. Let's try that again. Big letter O and a little slash in the corner, like a little diagonal tail. That's the uppercase letter Q. All right, let's check out the lowercase Q. Well, that's different, right? Yes, it kind of does look like a backwards P a little bit. Here's our P. You're right. So let's figure out how to make this lowercase Q. All right, start at the top. You're gonna make a little circle. Then you're gonna come down with a line. And then you're gonna give it a little tiny line like that. Okay, let's do that again. That's a little tricky. I'll do one down here. You're gonna do a little letter O. Then you're gonna come down with a straight line and then give it like a little backwards tally or a little backwards check. You got it. Good job, my friends. Okay, let's erase our letter Q and work on our final letter for today. And that is called what? R, R. R. And R sounds like R, R. Very good. Okay, let's figure out how to do this letter R. Yes, you're right. It does look like a P a little bit. So let's keep that in our mind. Let's start at the top. We're going to draw a straight line down. And let's make that letter P. Since you guys are already so good at it, come around, letter P. And then what else does the letter R need? Right, it looks like another little leg. So right from in here, you're going to come down diagonally with a little leg. And that's how we make our uppercase R. Let's check that out. Let's do that again. Start at the top and go down. Pick up your marker. You're going to come around. And then you're going to give it that little leg. And that's our uppercase letter R's. Very good. All right, let's check out the lowercase R. Not too bad, right? We could do this. We got it. All right. Start at the top. Make your line down. Then you're going to follow it back up again. And you're going to go around just a little bit, like a little hook. And give it a little hook. Let's try that again over here. We're going to go down, we're going to follow it back up again, like we do with our other letters, and then you're going to give it a little hook, come around. And that's how we make the lowercase R. Great job, my friends. Once you get learning how to write these letters very good on this side of your dry erase board, flip it around and practice writing your uppercase and lowercase on the line side. See if you can get them filled up that way. As always, make sure you take pictures and send them to Miss Janelle and I because we love to see your work. Have a great day. Bye-bye.